Seeing that, I would like to begin by recognizing that the land on which we gather has been inhabited for the last 15,000 years. We gather on the traditional and sacred territories of the Huron-Wendat, the Haudenosaunee, and most recently the Mississaugas of the Credit River. This territory is covered by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, an agreement between the Haudenosaunee Confederacy and the Ojibwa and their allies to peaceably share and care for the resources in and around what we now call the Great Lakes. While we honor the Indigenous community who have been living and working on this land, it is also important to recognize, to acknowledge the harms and wrongdoings of the past. We dedicate this concert to the thousands of residential school children who have suffered and died, and endeavor to forge a greater path toward reconciliation.
Concert is hope for the world. And I'm not going to lie, when we were asked to share our hopes to include in this performance, I was stumped. We are living in a time that makes hope challenging. The pandemic, war, an environmental crisis, economic hardship, the growing hate against minority groups, particularly trans people, and the clawing back of hard-won human rights victories all across the board. How can we have hope in a time like this? The truth is, I spent the last couple of years not allowing myself to hope. That's how I survived. I shut down. I self-isolated, and I just moved. But surviving is not enough. And I know that I deserve to feel safe enough to hope and change, screw up, make mistakes, and learn. Those are things that I wish for all of you, too. We all deserve to hope. We all need hope. So, thank you for joining us tonight and supporting the singing out community. And I hope that as we're singing, you can hear pride, love, and hope in every single note. Happy Pride.
Get to play. I hope for a future our youth can look forward to.
I hope we can stop focusing on all the differences and start focusing on all the things we have in common.
I hope for a world where the powerful can't take so easily things that don't belong to them. Homes, countries, rights, resources, histories, futures, bodies, and lives.
Let us pause in life's pleasures and count its many tears, while we all sought sorrow with the poor. There's a song that will linger forever in our ears. Oh, hard times come again. Tis the song, the sigh of the weary. Hard times, come again no more. Many days you have lingered around my cabin door. Come again no more.
While we sing mirth and beauty and music light and gay, there are thrill forms fleeting as the dawn. focus that would be there on that condition for our children and how it's done.
I hope that those with mental illnesses are able to get the support and treatment they need for healthy lives. I hope we will not regress and go back to a time when persons cannot choose what happens within their own bodies.
Don't run. Thank you. is enjoying the show so far. So after this next number, there will be a 20-minute intermission. Is anyone feeling lucky this evening? Because during intermission, we'll be continuing to sell our gift basket raffle tickets. There are 3 fabulously themed gift baskets and a pair of Apple AirPods Pro, which retail at $329. The themes of the gift baskets are massage and spa, which includes a 60-minute massage gift certificate, games and leisure, which includes the game Cranium Wow, and romantic evening, which includes a gift card for a Seduction Boutique. With tickets only $5 each, it's a great way to support the choir and win some cool stuff. So head on out to the lobby during intermission, where you'll find our friendly and charming ticket vendors. We accept cash, and we have 2 machines for credit and debit. The draw will take place for the baskets immediately after the intermission, right before the second half of the show.
When I think of hope, I often think of my great-grandparents and what they were hopeful for as they crossed the ocean by boat from a life of pogroms in a part of Russia, ironically present-day Ukraine, looking for a better, safer life. It is amazing to me to think of how this one choice changed their lives forever. When my cousin Corey was 14, and happens to be in the audience tonight, and his sister Tammy was 17, they set forth on a great challenge and wrote a musical about our family. Corey wrote the score, and Tammy wrote the book. It was called A Family Torn, and it told the story of Esther, my great-grandmother, coming to Canada on a chance invitation from family already here. The ticket was meant for her older sister, Hannah, but Hannah insisted Esther go in her place. My great-grandfather, Sam, soon followed behind to meet Esther in Montreal, and when it was time for her sisters to join them, they ended up on a boat set for Argentina. Sadly, the family was torn apart, never to see each other again. Esther never saw her sisters or parents again and had to live with this trauma. But her focus was a better life for her future children, and she was determined to make this happen. When my great-grandparents were settled in Montreal, they took what was a very hard life and decided to make something for their family. Sam would deliver bread each morning on horse and buggy, and Esther insisted he start selling for pickles and herring. As time went on, the pickles and herring sold so much that it grew and grew, becoming one of Canada's largest pickle companies called Mrs. White's. My great-grandmother's image eventually became the face of the labels, and my grandfather, Harry, took over the business from his parents, and then my dad, Simon, took it over from him. When I was in high school, my dad sold the company, but a love for pickles flows through our veins, and the legacy of Mrs. White's continues to this day, and is now known as White's. When I was a kid, Mrs. White's pickles were sold everywhere in Montreal, from Schwartz's to Moishe's. Growing up, I would work every summer at the factory making pickles. On Halloween, we would give out individually packaged pickles to trick-or-treaters. To this day, I still meet people who lived in my area and know my house as the Pickle House. These are some of the fondest memories I have growing up, and I am so grateful for Esther and Sam moving to Canada. The life I have as a proud queer food stylist in Toronto would never be possible for not all the hard and tiring work they did and the sacrifices they made. A Family Torn first had its production at my cousin Corey's high school and then a full production at the D.B. Clark Theatre in Montreal. I was in the high school performance when I was 12, and one might say my performance was beyond incredible. Sadly, I did not make it to the bigger stage. I know what you're thinking, how is this possible? I am still at 44 thinking the same thing. I do think it had something to do with the fact that the character I played was meant to be 11, and by the time the production was on stage, I may have been 14. I guess this is fair, but I will be dealing with this issue in therapy later this week. Hashtag going over it. Singing Out is so excited to perform this song from the finale of the play. At this point in the play, Esther's parents are singing about their daughters leaving home, while the sisters are singing about being on the other side of the world, and Esther and Sam are singing about starting their new life. The song goes on to talk about the trauma that comes from a family being torn apart, and the hope they have that one day they will be together again. A big thank you to Beth Hansen, our accompanist, for tirelessly working on arranging the song for a 4-voice park choir. We hope you enjoy this song as much as we do, and I dedicate this song to my late great grandparents and all the families that still, in this day and age, are torn apart, hoping for a better life.
Thank you. Thank you. Kellner, I'm the Assistant Artistic Director for Singing Out, and my hope for the world is for every voice to be heard. That was at the heart of our new project this year, to create a breakout ensemble that featured the trans and non-binary singers already in our choir. In our ensemble, singers get to use their voices in any way that feels good to them. As we work musically to expand outside of sometimes binary vocal roles in a space that is open to explore and change and grow. Today, we've chosen a powerful song for our debut by trans composer Pax Ressler, entitled Breathing is Alright. The song's lyrics come from a poem written and performed at an environmental protest by Miss Amy Russell. She and the activist group Philly Thrive fought and won to have an oil refinery in their neighborhood shut down. They activated the Philadelphia community to have their voices heard. When we hear every voice, the world becomes a better place. Miss Russell's community is cleaner, fewer people are getting sick, and workers are being more fairly compensated. With the composer's blessing, we borrowed some of Miss Russell's words to amplify our own voices too. The solos and lyrics have been created by members of this ensemble. And we're here to make a statement and be heard. As you hear our words and learn the refrain, please join in and sing along with us. We need you too. Together, we are so strong. Without further ado, I am proud to introduce to you one of the first of its kind in Canada, Singing Out's Trans and Non-Binary Ensemble.
Thank you.
I hope it's true what they say, that in the end, love wins.
The sun is rising. Thank you.
skip in your step and hope for the world. I hope during choir practice, Jody does not look in my general direction. I hope I can memorize the exam songs for the concert.
Thank you. everyone. I hope you're enjoying the show. Good evening. My name is Angel Calvillo, and I'm honored to be the president of the board of directors of Singing Out. If I had to describe this spring term, with very few words, it would be resiliency, innovation, and adaptability. And oh my, have we had to change, adapt, and pivot, and ensure that we remain on course. We navigated 1, 2, 3, I honestly lost count of how many waves we had to navigate this last term. It was challenging, but I'm extremely happy that we made it today. We're here celebrating Pride in person for the first time in what feels like forever. And you know what else we're celebrating? We're celebrating Singing Out's 30th year anniversary. It was back in 1992 when John Truck, who by the way was here today taking pictures for us, got together with a bunch of other LGBTQ folks to sing for the first time and sing for their lives. I am so thankful to them and to everyone who since then took over making this choir a community where we can come together and find our chosen family through pride, music, and belonging. There have been so many people involved as members, as volunteers, as directors on the board over the years whose tireless work and effort have made these 30 years possible. Our next season, 2022-2023, will be dedicated to celebrating the anniversary with a big bang. Who knows, maybe we'll even host a holiday party. I would like to appreciate the support of our government funder, the Ontario Arts Council, and our community partner, Regent Park Community Centre, who kindly hosts us every Tuesday for rehearsals. I would also like to thank our sponsor, the accounting firm, Friedman Case LLP, for the generous donation. It is through this type of support that our choir can continue ahead making music. Thank you to all the volunteers who participated this term in one of the several committees, music collaboration, diversity and inclusion, governance, and production, who put this show together, and it's amazing. A big shout out to the Macmillan Theatre and its amazing crew. Can I get a big round of applause for them? I would also like to thank the Copper Kids who have joined us for the second term in a row and lent their voices for our choir. It's honestly hopeful to see the artists of tomorrow. Thank you. Thank you to the Deputy Speaker who have joined us today to make this beautiful show sound even better. And I would like to thank our staff who worked tirelessly, creatively, to make us sound so good. Thank you to our artistic director, Jody Malone, our accompanist, Beth Hansen, and our assistant artistic director, Jackie Falconer, who worked very hard. Big round of applause. And to close it out, in the spirit of the concert theme, let me share my own hope. I hope that Singing Out continues to be a place where people can find community through pride, music, and belonging for at least another 30 years. Thank you very much.